Heidi here from Rain Country. God is good all the time. And I'm here for another frequently asked question. And today it's going to be about how long do herbs and spices last in food storage? And we're talking specifically about those that have been dried in some form. So right here in this section are just some of my own homegrown herbs that I've dehydrated and then vacuum sealed into jars. Now, with a lot of herbs, it's really not that big a deal to make sure they stay vacuum sealed if they're fully dried. As long as your jar is tightly closed, they should last for a very long time just like that. But I do still like to vacuum seal just to be sure. Now, generally speaking, most herbs and spices are said to last 2 to 3 years on the shelf, but it's going to be very rare that they'll actually spoil, and it's going to depend on the herb or the spice and how you have it preserved. The main thing you're looking at is over the long term, it's not that the herbs necessarily go bad after 2 or 3 years, it's that they start to lose their potency. So if you're looking at using them for flavor, or if you're looking at using them medicinally, or even just for their nutrient value, some of that is going to get lost over time. However, I do believe that you can prolong that time for far longer than 2 to 3 years, depending on how and where you store your herbs. So storing in glass jars is great. You're not exposing your herbs and spices to plastics or aluminum. And so that's, as far as health goes, it's going to be the safest way. However, the downfall to glass, besides the fact that you have to be more careful about where you store it, because in an earthquake, it can break. And also it's going to take up a little bit more room than certain other methods. But the number one thing is the fact that it's clear. And light exposure is one of those things you need to consider when storing your herbs. One of the things I've started doing is, besides having fairly heavy curtains over my pantry room, I have started putting some of the herbs that are more apt to be exposed to light into boxes to help keep them a little darker. You can also consider painting your jars. I've heard of people doing that. Or buying jars that are already dark for storing in. You know, you can get the amber ones now in the ball and some other ones. They're a lot more expensive though. And with canning jars being relatively difficult to find, though they should be back on the shelves now, at least at the time that I'm shooting this video, which is end of March that I'm shooting this. I know it's going to be late April at least before you see it, but there's really no need to spend the extra because there's so many other things you can do. Again, you can put it in boxes, you can paint them, or you can cover each individual jar, or you can also make, which is an old-fashioned way of doing things, even in basement pantries, people would actually make curtains that went over their shelves to make the shelves even darker. And that was for any of their canned goods, be they dried like this, or pressure canned, or water bath canned. Because the two main things, besides keeping them in a dry location, you don't want things in a humid or damp location. The other two things are keeping them as dark as possible and keeping them climate controlled, especially on the cool side. These are going to be the two number one things that are going to help preserve the benefits of your goods for a longer period of time. Now, when it comes to herbs and spices that I buy because I either can't grow them or haven't got to the point yet where I am growing them, such as my ground nutmeg, Ceylon cinnamon sticks, or the turmeric root powder, you can see I prefer buying them in brands like Star West, Frontier, or other brands that I can find that I feel are pretty good. I always read the ratings on them, and I always look for organic, that are already stored in Ziploc Mylar bags, because then I can just keep them in there. And that's going to keep them darker and well preserved. And so I don't have to jar these up. They're already going to be well sealed. And even like this one here, I've opened it. I've taken a few cinnamon sticks out of here and just resealed it up. Those cinnamon sticks last for a very long time. But again, keeping them in a cooler place will help them last longer. Again, this is just a sampling of the herbs that I have dehydrated up. So I've got nasturtium flowers, nasturtium leaves, rose petals, marshmallow leaves and flowers, elder flowers. Back here I have echinacea leaves and flowers, rosemary, red clover, pansies, dandelion, calendula, and oregano. So I'm pretty sure the next question is going to be, how will you know when they've got to that point where they're really no good anymore? Well, that's really simple. Three things you can look at: the color, the flavor, and the scent. Remember, it's not gonna hurt you. They're not gonna spoil. That's very, very unlikely. One way you can tell is that you can look at the color. It will help too if you have more recent jars that you can compare it to. This is 2020, so these I know are still gonna be really good. This is my rosemary. So if the color still looks pretty dark and you open it up, so this is vacuum sealed, there we go, and you smell it and it still has a very strong aroma, which this does, smells wonderful by the way, and you taste it and it still has a very strong flavor, especially things like rosemary, oregano, sage, those you'll know because they naturally have a very strong flavor. Those are some good ways to tell whether or not they're still good, which this obviously still is because it's only a year old. Now I have some oregano here. This oregano is from 2019 and it still has a very strong oregano smell. It also, another thing you can do is check to see if they still feel kind of crispy. That's a good thing too. And that way you'll know, like, this jar wasn't sealed, so I can tell, no, still crispy. Even without the jar being sealed, they still stayed crispy. And the smell is good. I'm not going to taste it right now, but I already know by the smell that the flavor is going to be quite strong and the color looks great. When you start to see the color fade, if it's lost a considerable amount of color, then you'll know it's probably not going to be much good. And of course, the flavor and the aroma, I think, are going to be the number one things. If it's still very strong, then yes, you know it's still good. Now, for things that don't have a very strong flavor, like red clover, for example, this right here is from 2019, so these are 2 years old. And I can tell by the color still looks as good as it did the day that I jarred it up. And so I know that's still going to be good. I can't go by the flavor or the scent because there really isn't much there once they're dehydrated up. There's not much there when they're fresh anyway. But the color is going to tell me quite a bit by looking at it like that. And as far as going longer than 2 to 3 years by using some of these other methods, you know, making sure you're keeping them cool and dark and dry and all that, I can't say for certain the amount, how many years past the 2 to 3 year mark you can go, but I would guess at least 5, maybe 10 or more. Again, it's going to depend on your area, how you have them stored. And then, of course, remembering to check the color, flavor, and aroma to get a good idea how good you think they are. All right. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video and I answered those questions. And I will be linking to my full FAQ playlist in the description box down below if you're curious about some other frequently asked questions that I've covered. And we'll see you in the next FAQ. Thanks for watching. Take care and God bless.